imperishable assets that is always increasing in value, the most solid security that human ingenuity has ever devised. It is the basis of all security, and about the only indestructible security. But of course, there are issues affecting real estate. With me in the studio today is Dr. Laide Okubena, who is very dynamic and passionate about real estate. Today we are looking at issues affecting real estate. Thanks and welcome to the program, Dr. Laide.
It's my honor.
We know you've been an advocate of real estate investment, but you know, like we all know that in everything, in every business, there are good side, there are bad side. And with what is going on in the country now, we know there are few issues affecting real estate. So in your own opinion, what do you think? Can you shed more light into the issues affecting real estate industry?
Issues affecting real estate industry, they have the positive side and they have the negative side. If we start with the positives are the part of the example of Alhaji Aliko Dangote, what he's doing in the Lekki Free Trade Zone, and the fact that the investment he's making is going to bring in a lot of jobs,
okay,
and it's going to bring a lot of development, employment opportunities, and foreign exchange to that area that is currently emerging in Lagos. And Lagos State also is part of it, and many international investors, companies are coming there, like Longbridge, the Chinese company. We have the American company, Kellogg's.
Okay.
We also have the Indomie Noodles company, Dufil. And they make power oil and Indomie noodles. And this Dano mill.
Okay.
And there's also the deep sea port, and proposed the emergence of the proposed international airport. And there's also going to be the proposed Fort Mainland bridge there. So these are big advantages that is making real estate, especially in this Lagos Island.
Okay, but looking at all these things you just mentioned, coming into just one area in Lagos, what do you think, from my own opinion, don't you think there will be negative sides to all this? With all these things coming, we are talking about pollution, we are talking about traffic. How do you think that place can accommodate all this investment coming together?
Okay. I think the legal, the government and the state government and the federal government, they have to do a lot of, so they have to give a lot of support to these, to these private investors, because currently the roads are just two lanes.
Okay.
Even I'll say when it's raining, it's not usually funny. Potholes, the drainage are not very good. Everybody's trying to avoid, in Nigeria now, they said, in Lagos especially, they said you no longer avoid portals, you select the portals to enter. And it's, at times it can damage, some people's car gets damaged or even because of the water there.
Okay, so what do you think the government can do to ease off the stress by the time all this government, all these companies come into play? What do you think the government can do to ease off at least
mobility
for citizens?
They have to create many alternative sources of transportation. Like I was hearing recently about Uber operating in the sea.
Okay.
And if they can create a waterway, ferry way, just like there's a waterway for those coming from Ikorodu to Aja, Ikorodu to Island, if there is a way that people that will be living, coming to work in that Ibejulekki, and maybe do that, and they want to go to Island, there's a sea way to pass, to make it very, very easy and to congest the road. And if there's a way they can also do railway along Lekki, it will also decongest it.
Okay. Okay, so again, let's now look at real estate investors. Some investor will tell you we want to invest, but we are scared, we are skeptical, we don't know the companies to partner with. What would you say to those kind of investors? You see that there are some companies that are not doing what they should do. Why do you think investors are a bit skeptical about investing?
Investors are a bit skeptical because at times what comes in the media, it can be what the negative news they hear in the media at times makes it scary.
Okay, like what and what?
Okay, like the recent one now we're hearing of a brand that was on social media, the Land Lagos.
Okay, that's the Land Lagos.
The Land Lagos issue.
Okay.
That an employee that was not happy with the his employers was now putting them in bad
shape.
And a lot of people were even sending me messages there. I was not even aware. They started getting different people sending me.
Okay, but do you think, you know, this just happened of recent. Do you think this can be the reason investors are being skeptical and scared about investing?
It's one of it, but there are other ones like relatives.
Okay.
Some relatives actually collect money. I mean, blood sisters, blood brothers. You collect money from your brother abroad that you want to buy land, and you now some relatives scam their relatives. They collect money that they want to buy land, but they don't use that money to buy land. They use it to do something else, and that relative loses trust. That's if his younger brother or elder sibling cannot use the money he was expecting to see a house or a property, and he came and he didn't see anything. So that's another scary part of real estate, trust. That who can I trust?
Okay, but you know, that is now relative. But what about real estate investors and real estate companies?
Okay, I think real estate investors have to do their own due diligence and thorough research, and they can secure the services of solicitors and their lawyers to do their background check on these companies, because we have a lot of good companies that are doing well, just like Red Bricks International that are doing the Amen Estate. They are like a leader in this, especially in that Ibeju-Lekki axis. They are making us proud, as at least we are seeing a lot of international artists come there to shoot videos, they come there to act movies, and even globally a lot of people are seeing that the a company like Red Bricks have reputation. But just for some other ones that are not up to the standard, those are the ones that they will need to make.
Okay, so invariably you are saying that before real estate investors invest, they should do their due diligence on the company.
Yes.
Now what about the real estate companies themselves? The real estate developers, are they meeting up to standard? Are they meeting up to people's expectation? Are they living up to their promises?
It's only some that feel that are actually matching up to the investors' promise. It's not all of them that do what they say they will do. Some will promise, but they will not fulfill.
And what do you think are those likely things that might be the cause of they not fulfilling what they promised?
Well, I'll say at times, a company buying a land that is supposed to be is a land for land banking, or a title that is not yet confirmed, like accession in process land that the investors cannot yet even start developing anything on it.
Okay.
So it's 50-50 when someone is buying a land that has accession in process and he cannot even touch it maybe in the next 5-6 years.
Okay.
So it keeps them uncertain. There's that uncertainty that this property I bought, I can't even do anything on it. So there's no trust. They won't be able to refer one to the bringing new people when they've not seen any progress done so far on the land. It's just the same bush. Some companies just have the same bushy land, no development, nothing. They just collect money and that's it. No progress, nothing.
Okay, so now we've talked about the issues affecting or things bordering on real estate investment on the part of the investor, and now on the part of the developer. So Dr. Laide, you will talk to the developers watching us, you will talk to the investors watching us. What are those key things you tell them to watch out for in 30 seconds?
I would say developers try to always keep to the promises you make to these real estate investors. Anything you tell them to do, that you're going to do, try to make sure you keep your own part of the agreement and the promise. If this is done, there will be no problem.
Thank you so much for coming. I hope you have to be able to do it. Join us again next time. Bye.